Hello, everyone, and welcome to the first ever episode of the Simply Wellness Kitchen. I have decided to make up a recipe today, and I thought I would take you along for the ride. We have these really beautiful lamb chops that have just been rinsed and patted dried that we got from one of our local farms, and I can't wait to try them. And I've been thinking about what I want to do with them today. I think I'm going to grill them this afternoon, but I wanted to get them sitting in a little bit of a marinade before then. So here we're going to have just a pretty simple marinade. We're going to start with dicing up an onion. This is a nice fresh garden onion. And then we're going to take a lemon. I'm lucky enough to have a beautiful lemon tree in my backyard. And squeeze all that lovely juice in there. And you cannot ever go wrong with garlic. Since this is a marinade, I'm going to go ahead and press this garlic, I think. Alright, and then I was thinking, to me, lemon and parsley go really nicely together. So I've got a bunch of fresh parsley from our local farm stand, because my parsley is not big enough yet to want to start taking it out of my garden. Some people are lucky enough to live in places where they get fresh herbs all year round. Parsley and cilantro are not ones that I can grow all the time around here, though. We're just gonna stir this up a little bit, see what that looks like. It's looking pretty nice. And of course, we want a little olive oil. Approximately a quarter of a cup, we'll say. This is how I cook, by the way. Else would be really good in this one is a little apple cider vinegar. We are going to take our unfiltered raw, just a little bit, definitely no more than what the lemon produced in terms of juice. Get the smell and the flavor. That's really awesome. Okay. Now with the salt and pepper, I'm gonna go ahead and actually put that directly on to the lamb chops and rub that in a little bit. So we'll do a little salt first on that side, a little pepper. And go ahead and rub that in. Over the top of it. That looks amazing. And I chose that particular Pyrex because I have a very handy lid. I can go right on top. I'm gonna go ahead and pop that in the fridge for the day. and go to work, do my thing, and come back in the evening and grill these up with some fresh leafy greens. We're gonna have kale on the side, and I haven't decided, maybe a butternut squash or a quinoa to go with it. So stay tuned on how these come out. I will show you later on this evening. Hey, welcome back to the second half of this experiment with our lamb chops today. I just pulled them out of the fridge, and I actually want them to sit at room temperature for half an hour or so before they go on the grill. But here they are, and I can tell you it smells delicious. So we're just gonna set those over here, and I have decided, I think, we're gonna have some really nice kale to go with it. And I've decided to do, I had a few potatoes and one sweet potato left in my batch, so I've decided to do that with them. And it's pretty warm where I am right now. I think, you know, our high was about 90 degrees today. So I don't really want to turn on my oven to roast these. So I'm actually gonna roast them out on the gas grill because that works just fine. I'm gonna flavor them in two different ways, just because if I had more potatoes, I would just do potatoes, or if I had more sweet potatoes, I'd just do sweet potatoes, but I don't have enough of either, so I'm gonna do some of both. Now these are great potatoes and sweet potatoes. They also came from our farm stand. So I am an organic, they're organic and or some organic farms locally. So I don't actually bother to peel them at all. Instead, I really enjoy having the skin on when I roast them. I think it gives a nice kind of added crisp and flavor to it. So I just chunk them and stick them in a bowl. For the sweet potatoes, you just take a little olive oil, little salt, and some, another one, some garlic powder. Sprinkle that on. Mix that around. On one side, I'm going to see if I can do the whole thing on one tray because this tray actually fits under. We have a small gas grill. We typically use our charcoal grill a lot more. So we'll just set those aside. Now let's go ahead and do the potatoes. And I want to say, I want to point out so far for this meal, I spent less than 10 minutes this morning getting the lamb chops ready. And I just spent another 5 minutes washing the kale. It's sitting in the sink right now. And scrubbing the potatoes. That's all the time I put into this meal so far. So we're at about 15 minutes of total time. And this is the first time I've done this. I'm not entirely sure what I'm doing. Just sort of winging it. So with the potatoes, I want to mirror the flavor of the lamb chops. So I'm actually going to do a lemon garlic potato. So we'll just take half a lemon this time. And this time, we're going to do olive oil also. I'm gonna use this really awesome garlic salt from Trader Joe's. I do not have a Trader Joe's near me. When I get there, it is one of my favorite things. And then we're also gonna chop up the rest of the parsley from the bunch that I had earlier. Also. little bit. Take our tray, put these over on this side. There. When I do potatoes like this after I get them on the tray, I really like to take my salt and pepper and get the lid off with wet hands. Just crack a little bit on top. And those are ready to go on the grill. All right, I am back again. We're gonna cook the kale this time. Had to take just a quick pause and go out and watch my kids who are scooter surfing outside, apparently. It's their new invention on their scooters. Awesome. Okay, so for the kale, I'm one of those people, I put onion in just about everything. I actually put garlic in just about everything too, but when cooking greens, if I'm gonna saute them, I might as well start with a little onion. So I'm gonna put a couple tablespoons of olive oil at the bottom of my cast iron pan. If you have never cooked with cast iron, I highly recommend it. They are amazing, and if you take good care of them, it actually acts almost like a nonstick. So we'll turn that on just to heat up the cast iron. Chop up my onion. And in between the last video and this one, aside from watching the scooter surfing, all I did was go out, turn on my grill was warming up, and put the potatoes on the grill. So it was literally about 30 seconds. All right, got those. Add them to my pan. When I cook onions, most of the time my preference, there's still a little parsley on the cutting board, but that is okay. My preference when I'm cooking onions is to do them slower and kind of slower and on a lower heat. And I just find that really kind of releases the flavor. They don't get browned and they're pretty gorgeous by the end. So I'll just stir those around. Let them get going. Once the pan gets hot, then I turn it down to low. Nice thing about cast iron is it's nice and even heat across the whole thing. I don't know. All right, so now I have my washed kale over here in the sink. I hear you draining that. I don't actually care how dry it gets. The added moisture from the kale just helps it for steam saute once I get it into the pan. So this is two nice bunches of kale. And I'm going to chop that up just a little bit. Take a look at this kale in here and see how that's doing. It's been about 5 minutes. And it's looking pretty fabulous. It's at the point where I feel like I could just take a fork and eat it. And that is totally cooked. Nice soft onions, nice soft kale. I'm gonna just turn turn that off. We can leave that be just how it is. I just put the pork chops on the grill, and I've got all this wonderful liquid left in the pan where they were marinating. So the pork chops will cook for 3 to 5 minutes on each side, depending on how thick your cut is. I keep saying pork chops. They're lamb chops. Lamb chops will cook for 3 to 5 minutes on each side, depending on how thick your cut is. But I'm gonna just take the rest of this sauce and simmer it while the lamb chops are cooking. And that will reduce the sauce and cook any of the meat drippings that are in there. And then we'll have that to kind of drizzle over the top when we're done. So that will be just a little added tastiness. And I might just increase the quantity a little bit. Just take another half a lemon or a whole lemon. We'll see how much juice that is and squeeze that in also. So I'm really making this lemon, parsley, garlic kind of reduction. I don't know if you can really call it that, but I will. And we had that apple cider vinegar in here as well. So we're gonna just let this, and I literally am gonna just let it sit and simmer. I've set the timer right now. You can't quite see it. All right, there it is. Counting down, that's for the first side of the lamb chops. So when that goes off, I'm gonna go outside and flip them over and come back, set it again for another 3 minutes probably. And if this simmers for most of that time, then that'll be just about what we need. All right, we are back one more time and we've got everything cooked here. So we've got a little potato and sweet potato. Really amazing looking lamb chops. Beautiful fresh kale. And we'll just take a little of the sauce. Stick it right on top of my lamb chop here. And there you have it. That is dinner for tonight.